Alright, here we are for round three. We're on the play. Yeah, this looks like just a fine, normal sort of hand. Our opponent will probably think we're playing shardless also, which is nice. A little upside. I guess basic forest kind of gives that game away, though, maybe. You never know. Our hand could just be sort of a funny shardless bug deck hand. Not storm again, please. All right, well, we get to cast our Shardless Agent on turn two. That seems pretty good. Question is if we get a basic or not. I think not, because our opponent has it doesn't have anything on board. If they played like a turn one Delver, I would strongly consider getting a basic, but they didn't, so I'm not that worried about it. And we get a brainstorm. That works. Okay, well, that's fine. So I guess we're playing against some kind of Delvery deck. Oh, okay, that's also fine. I kind of actually like that now. It seems kind of likely that our Aluren will just resolve. That's pretty sweet. We are getting wasted. That is really surprising to me. I think that is a I'm not going to say a huge mistake, but definitely a mistake on our opponent's part. I think like they know our hand doesn't have a lot of gas, and I think it's just good for us to get wasted there. Like we get an extra turn with Death Rite, and they know that we have plenty of lands, and our opponent just has nothing going on at the moment. So I went ahead and ate main phase there because I didn't want to get fetch land into Gurmag Angler'd. So they're gonna cast a Ponder. Choose to not shuffle. That is fine. Ooh, I kind of like that. So we could jam Aluren this turn. I actually don't want to do that. I think it's better to wait until we can pay for days. I do kind of like just Volrath strongholding and getting back Shardless Agent, though. That sounds kind of appealing. Looks like this is going to be kind of a grindy game. Our opponent is not doesn't have a lot going on. There's not much point in eating something main phase with Death right here. We can't keep them off Gurmag Angler anyway, so I'd rather just be able to use Volrath Stronghold. Okay. chose to not shuffle. What else you got? Nothing. Well, we'll go ahead and Shardless Agent then. And I think I'm going to just leave up a swamp here to Deathrite with. Ooh, alright. Let's see what's going on over there. I'm going to name... Doesn't seem very likely that our opponent has some sort of combo. I think I'm just going to still name Force of Will. Because we have Aluren to try and force through. Alright, they did have one. That's good. And they have a Delver that they chose to not play. And a Bolt that they chose to not play. That's all very interesting to know. And I think we'll just pass. I don't need a Deathrite in main phase here. It is annoying if they Gurmag Angler us, but I think if they had that, they would have just cast it last turn instead. And this way we might be able to snag Cabal Therapy, which is, I assume, what our opponent is setting up here. They're going to Therapy our Abrupt Decay. They're going to Bolt our Deathrite first. All right, well, let's hit something out of your graveyard. So now what, they're going to cast Therapy plus Delver this turn, probably. I'm kind of hoping that our opponent is so concerned about Aluren that they flash back that Therapy with their Delver, because I think we can win with just what we have. If they do that, I think we'll go ahead and Volrath Stronghold back Deathrite. Okay, they did not do that. So, or I guess we don't know yet. They could still do that. Yep. All right. Yeah. I'm just gonna Volrath Stronghold back that Deathrite and cast it. That seems like a pretty good use of our turn with our opponent at 8. And we know one of their cards is Daze, so they have one unknown card. I feel like we could run into trouble if it's like a young Pyromancer, but there's not. I mean, Gurmag Angler would also be annoying, but I think we could maybe even beat that. Delver definitely is not good enough. Kind of surprised they didn't cast the Brainstorm first. Because I don't think Delver is really the threat that they want. They're kind of behind in the race. If you cast Brainstorm with this, you could find Gurmag Angler plus Bolt, which would be the best. Ooh, alright, I ain't mad at that. That means even if our opponent finds a Bolt, they're still dying to our Deathrites. Or they still need to come up with an additional block, like maybe blocking with Delver, which I would definitely be okay with. Ooh, I don't think that was what they meant to do, because they drew the Daze first. Although, they're so far behind, it probably doesn't matter. They have to find Lightning Bolt exactly, and then Lightning Bolt Deathrite, and then have to block Shardless Agent with Delver while we have a Volrath Stronghold in play, which obviously is a pretty unappealing idea. Well, I'll keep sideboarding as we have done, It's worked out pretty well so far, so hopefully it does so again. All right, here we go for game two. All right, here we are for game two. We're on the draw. This is kind of a risky hand. I think I'm going to keep it anyway, though. Brainstorm really does cure all ills. And we have Deathrite as well, so I think, yeah, it is awkward that we can't cast them both off the same land with that, unless we want to fetch a non-basic, which I don't totally want to do. But I think this hand is good enough to justify keeping. I'm going to go get an underground C. Could be Trop, actually. Trop is... no, underground C it is. Please don't have Days into Wasteland. Alright. Step one. Delver not flipping is actually kind of concerning because it feels like that makes Wasteland more likely. Yeah, there it is. Okay. This is going to be one of those games. Well, that happens sometimes. Maybe we should have mulliganed. I don't know. The sequence that punishes us is pretty specific here. That's not a great one. Would have been nice if that tapped for blue mana. Or could cast Baleful Strix even. Yeah, now it's really awkward because we can't even... our Underground Sea is gone and we don't have a second one in the deck. So we can't even cast... There's no land that taps for blue and black mana left in our deck. So we can't get a land that lets us cast Brainstorm and Abrupt Decay in one nice package. Which would definitely be what I want to do. Alright, probably gonna name Abrupt Decay. Yeah, that's I think what I would name as well. Well, we have some outs at least. That's not one of them. I don't think we're gonna be winning this game. I just think even, like, I'm trying to imagine what the best conceivable draw is. I guess it's like a blue source into a Deathrite Shaman, and our opponent's hand is just horrible. And even then, I wouldn't feel super favored. I'd feel like we could, you know, we would have to claw back into it. And that's, I think that's about the best I could imagine us drawing. Oh gosh. If he names Brainstorm, I'm just going to concede. Okay. We're not dead yet. Okay, that'll do it. We're not technically dead, but we're going to one off double off the Deathrite activation plus the Delver, so maybe I'm supposed to mulligan that hand. So on the draw, I think I want to try out a Toxic Deluge over probably the second Dreamstalker. All right, let's give this a try. All right, here we are for game three. We get to go first. I think this hand is a keep. It's not amazing, but it's not terrible either. It has... It is weak to get to getting our recruiters taken away, I guess. That's a downside. Hopefully we don't get therapied too hard. Yeah. Oh my. Well, that was unexpected. I was expecting we were getting probe therapied for our recruiters, but instead our opponent has just kept a zero lander with just probe. I don't quite understand that. Anyway, I guess we will go fetch Trop and jam this guy. Ooh, Polluted Delta. It's better than some of our draws, but it would have been nice to get something that could get our Taiga so we could actually cast Imperial Recruiter. Alright, they got their land. They can take away our recruiters, I guess. Our hand is pretty nothing, I guess, if that does happen. Yeah. We get to jam an Aluren into a potential daze if we want to on our next turn. Hopefully we just draw like a Shardless Agent to cast. It hasn't come up often for me that I've wanted an extra green fetch when I didn't have one, although that's terrible. Like, this would have been so good last turn, and now it's just a complete blank. That's pretty frustrating. I think I'm still just going to go ahead and jam Aluren. Maybe not, though. Maybe it's better to wait to play around days. Probably is. Like, I think Polluted Delta is still the better card to play than like an off-color, you know, a not on-color green land. Okay, now I'll play Aluren. I guess I should attack first. There's no reason to get our Baleful Strix ambushed after our Aluren resolves. I'm not really worried about what our opponent could put in here because Minister of Pain actually kills almost all of it. I think that this is likely to get forced anyway, because why would you keep a zero lander without force? I can't really imagine that. Oh, okay. What you got? So maybe they have a force? I'm just gonna jam this Baleful Strix for sure. Maybe even the Minister of Pain also. Yeah, I'm just gonna play everything. It does really feel like there's a force of will coming soon here. Maybe not. Alright, I'll ditch the Strix to get rid of that Vendilion click. And I'll get this Deathrite Shaman into play as well. Do you want to take a Toxic Deluge out of my hand? You do? I don't know what to make of that. I was really not expecting for that to happen. I mean, they must have Gurmag Angler, but that's not even good on this board, and I definitely wouldn't pay 5 life and a spell to remove it. It's very surprising to me. Okay, I don't mind being wasted in this spot either. Have more than enough lands. And here comes the aforementioned Gurmag Angler. I guess they can remove enough stuff that we can't kill them with Deathrite Shaman, and then maybe that's not so bad. Yeah. They still can't attack into this Baleful Strix, though. I don't know. I don't quite get this. Ooh, that's nice. So we can pick up Baleful Strix and replay it. I guess I'll just do that now. I'll attack for one and then do that. There's a little bit of risk here if they Force of Will the Dreamstalker, but that's fine. We'll take 5 damage to force through to get a force on our pretty bad card. Yeah, that is a-okay with me. Okay. What is going on? I don't understand our opponents, like, huh. I mean, that's good. That's really good for them, but why did they not play those 2 Pyromancers in if they're going to play Force already? That doesn't make any sense. So now we don't go off if we draw Imperial Recruiter. Oh no, we do still, because we can go get Witness and then Witness back Dreamstalker. Okay, that's all good then. And Wasteland us, we'll eat Force of Will. Boo. Yeah, I think we just pass here. Opponent has no good attacks. Oh, but he's getting in anyway. Okay. Well, I'm fine with that trade. Don't mind that at all. I guess we'll go ahead and eat some creature from their graveyard. Keep that life total high. Alright, that's not bad. We can can deal with a Delver now if it flips. Flips with Gitaxian Probe. I'm just going to kill it now. Might as well get Trop. Actually, we could kill a Young Pyromancer, but I don't think the Young Pyromancer tokens even matter all that much. So we could eat something out of the graveyard, but I want to eat the Delver, or I want to eat the Probe, I mean, which I'm going to do now. They can still cast Gurmag Angler, but this way they at least take the 2 damage. And it seems likely that that's what our opponent's last card is. Gurmag Angler makes by far the most sense. Because they bricked off Delver and then didn't cast it off Aluren, so... Yeah, it is indeed a Gurmag Angler. That's not good. No point in casting that, and we might draw Brainstorm. So I guess we're just passing. And I guess we'll start eating creatures out of our graveyard. I don't really want to eat... Well, there's no downside to eating Abrupt Decay, per se, but there's not a ton of upside either. Well, maybe that's not true. Maybe then our opponent's Ponders become kind of bad. And they can't really cast Ponder or Brainstorm at some point. Yeah, I guess I will eat the Abrupt Decay, because if we draw Eternal Witness, I'm not getting it back anyway. Interesting attack. Definitely going to leave my Death Rite around for at least one more turn. Yeah, I'm going to eat the Abrupt Decay. That's a good draw. Hope they didn't draw a blast, a red blast. That's also a good draw. Okay. Now we could do it. We can basically pay a life to draw a card at this point at will. I guess we should do it at least once. There's no downside to the first one. Because it doesn't actually cost us a life. And I think we'll pay like 2 life. I don't want to die to nonsense, so I'm going to try to avoid that. We can also Minister of Pain if we need to. We have like the flashback on that with the Cavern Harpy. Ugh. I'll do one more. I think going to 5 is fine because we can go up to 7 with Death Rite. Jesus. Okay, well, that's not good. And we can always do more at instant speed, and we can cast all of our creatures at instant speed, so if we find the thing that we're looking for, then we'll still just win. They bricked off flipping their Delver. I guess I should have thought a little bit about Minister of Painting during their upkeep, but it's fine. Yeah, no good attacks. So now I just want to gain life, now that every life is worth a card. Oh, okay. Well, that just kills, so... What I'm gonna do... Oh, I guess I can just cast it. I forgot our opponent was so low that they just die to this. Like, we don't even have to be concerned about any trickery. Alright, that works. That was a weird game. I would have been pretty annoyed if we had lost, just because our opponent kept such a terrible opening hand. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Looks like this deck is pretty effective at beating up Delver, and Storm is pretty rough. We'll be back next week. See you then.